And today we're going to be talking about Jezebel.
Yes.
The wife of the king. Would she be queen Jezebel?
Are we ready for this? Yes, she was.
We're ready.
Are we ready for this?
Yes.
Okay, let me just say this, because I want to say it each time, at least. This, we are not ever to make anybody our enemy. We are to pray for all people who are against the Bible in their actions. This is not saying that the people in there are the same, but they are following a template, as in the same way as Israel's fall, this links to how America has fallen from God. So having said that, okay, so we've been looking at the mystery of the kings, which is the first time I'm sharing this outside of Beth Israel, and that is that there's a template in the fall of Israel, not only the harbingers, and that's got to actually overlaps with the harbingers, but same northern kingdom, where you're going to see this amazing parallel in the in the fall of America from God. You're going to see, so we looked the first time at the first one, which is King Ahab, or Ahab, who was a man who was, it says, you know, the commentaries will say he was strategic, tactical, but he was also, he had some moral weakness as well, but he helped accelerate the fall of his nation, the spiritual fall. Well, we looked at what happened, and this is matching up, it's going to match up even more, in the Clinton administration. Bill Clinton was known as all that, and he accelerated abortion, accelerated all these things. He was the first president in history to come out all in favor behind all these things, which were anti the Bible and all these things. So we had that. Now let's go to the next template. The next template is he wasn't alone. Ahab, it wasn't just Ahab, it was Ahab and Jezebel. Who was Jezebel? She was a Phoenician princess who was probably given to Ahab in marriage as probably a political alliance. Her real name was Isabel. That's the real, we call her Jezebel, Isabel. She was raised worshiping Baal. Her father was a priest of Baal and Ashtoreth, and who actually killed the king and became king in his place. And that was her child. That's what she was raised at. And so she came to the new land. She came to Israel, but she, instead of adapting to Israel, she took her ways and sought to impose it on Israel. She sought to impose unbiblical ways on a biblical nation, or new morality on not against the traditional morality. And so the template of Ahab and Jezebel is a strategic but morally weak king who is, the Bible says, was incited or goaded by his wife, provoked by his wife. She, in many ways, Jezebel was the power behind the throne in many ways. To much of the people of Israel, she was seen as a foreigner in a foreign morality. She wasn't trusted, undoubtedly, by many. And she did have an agenda there. So it was unprecedented in Israel's history, because the first time you have a co-regency, you've got the king, it wasn't just King Ahab, it was Ahab and Jezebel, major, major person. So here we go. And again, we love the people, pray for the people. They don't know what they're doing in this respect. But the phenomenon of here it is. In American history, we had another unprecedented phenomenon. For the first time, we had in the White House, we had not only a president, but we had, in a sense, a co-president. And they even said, you're getting two for one. We had, with Bill Clinton, we had Hillary Clinton. She was centrally involved with her husband's rise. Even as early as the 70s, she's saying, he's going to become the president. In the 70s, he's going to be the president of the United States. The template of Jezebel is one that, and let me say also something else. It's not that every part of a template has to be the thing, but there are key signs in it, is that a woman marries a man from a conservative land, but she brings in her own values. Well, Hillary Clinton married Bill Clinton. Bill Clinton is from a conservative land. He's from the Bible Belt. And when she came as the wife of the governor, she was seen as, you know, really having another kind of morality. She did not take the name Clinton. She refused at the beginning. She was only Hillary Rodham. And that was seen as almost like she was imposing another morality. She was a radical feminist, and here in the Bible Belt. And finally, he was defeated for as governor. And so what happened is they believed a lot of it was some of it was because of this, of her. And so she only then adopted the name Clinton. It was only, and they got back in power. She embraced a morality that was in so many ways opposed to the clear biblical values, a new morality. She held on to her own, that identity. In the template of Ahab and Jezebel, You have, again, this co-regency. Well, never in history, never in American history did we have this. But she actually moved into the White House and actually had an office in the White House. The aides called it Hillary Land, that she actually ruled with her husband, a co-regency. In the template of Jezebel, you have the king is kind of has a weakness about him. You know, he has, but the queen is considered to be the harder one. And that's exactly what you had as well. Influencing. They said that Clinton, they said, never said no to his wife in these things. Now, it says that she goaded him or incited him. Now, one of the key things about Baal worship, and it's not that she knows it or they know it, but one of the things of Baal worship is the killing of babies. There has never been, and this is the key thing here, there's never been anybody in American history, in American, the spotlight of national politics, who has been so pro-abortion as Hillary Clinton. Nobody. Never has been. And that is the template of Jezebel. And with the people who were actually, who were of traditional values, who opposed Ahab and the prophets and all that, Ahab lashed out at them, so did Jezebel, and so did Hillary Clinton in the whole thing with this. When Clinton, when he signed those executive orders, fourth day of his presidency, wiping away all the, expanding abortion all over the place, the one who incited him to do that was Hillary Clinton. They said, their staff said, don't do it. She incited him. One of the things that Hillary Clinton was known for in the White House was to try to nationalize health care, as we know. One of the things about that was it involved abortion on demand. People don't realize it. That plan would have had that everybody was paying for abortion. In the template of Jezebel, she's trying to force the worship of Baal, which involves the killing of babies on all America. Now, again, not that she knows it here, but that's the exact template here. Now, let me say there's more about this, but let me say something. Now, you think most believers think of Ahab and Jezebel, and they think, okay, you know, they came and then their reign ended. Didn't quite happen. What happened was the reign of Ahab ended, but Jezebel went on.